All right. Need to get my camera set. Not really sure if my butt's gonna be in the way or not, and there's a little bit of red reflected light from this umbrella that's over us. It's also very hot, so I think that it might overheat, but I'm gonna try. I'm working on an 18 by 24 canvas, painting our garden. So thought it'd be interesting to see how it works with such a large canvas. So I kind of have an idea of the composition that I want, and I'm just gonna get started. So when I use my hands as a viewfinder, I kind of look for what's in the middle, like the center point, and that kind of gives me a gauge for the rest of the painting. So this post is pretty much in the center. Maybe a little bit to the right. Top is pretty close there. It goes to about a quarter way in. Down here's the leafy greens. You can see a bit of the chicken coop out there, which I like. And then this door, this crooked door coming at us. So I'm looking at the negative space, as usual, of what's around this door. Is here. Okay. So it's kind of drawn in with this blue pencil. And right now I'm going to put in, I'm just going to try to cover the canvas in a really light wash to kind of show me where everything is, and then I can build up the paint. And this light yellowish green is really nice, and it's gonna go behind all this foreground plants. My inspiration for this composition was the hops that are going over the fence, which I thought were really pretty. I'm not being too specific on the color right now. I can be a little more free. It's more just for the placement of things. I actually want to do this green to be kind of a yellowish so that it will shine through. I'll try to leave some of it. I'm not very good at leaving things, but I'm gonna try. Gonna get a lot of green in this. Now I got some straw. Which I'll kind of hint at. Probably not going to be very responsive to comments because it's hard to concentrate on the painting and then go back and forth to the screen, but I'll try to answer any questions later if you have any. I darker paint to push back this background. It is already really hot. Not sure if I'm gonna go with last. I'll try. So we have these bigger hedges in the background. And they're pretty much the darkest thing in this image. So yeah. Got some trees over here. Trying to remember where everything is. And I'm gonna just hint at the darker parts. Weak, and holding this brush makes my hand really tired, and that's pretty sad. Go these. Got this plant going all the way down. It's the door. There, pretty much done. Not really. Alright. I think that's going to help a lot. Let's give it more structure. This door has been moving around, but it's okay. Is really hitting me on the right side. I need to get a bigger umbrella. Alright. So now we've got an idea, or you can see it a little better anyway. These shadows are pretty dark, kind of purple blue. I think it's important to get the lighting of your subject in as soon as possible, because the light does change pretty quick. And there's a some of this, these really bright flowers that I see. Got them in back here, so I remember. Probably go over them later. Totally aren't that big, but alright. And now I'm gonna put in the chicken coop. It's all white, but the light that I'm seeing is reflecting from the sky, so it actually looks kind of blue right now. You can just see a hint of it. So I'm not going to go into too much detail on the coop. But I'm going to try to define it. Putting in some of these shadows. You can see it. I know it's a little dark. So there's some vines growing up in the coop that I really love, and I've been wanting to paint the coop too. A little bit of green. So, I've got it all pretty much blocked in at this point, and I'm going to pay attention to what I really want to focus on, which is the house plant. And the shadow of the leaves are a nice bluish green, but where the light is going through, it's a really vibrant, hot green. So hopefully I can capture that. And it's gonna be pretty vague, but I do want to probably go back in and identify some of the shapes of the leaves, just a couple. Right now I'm being pretty vague with it because I will be going behind it and, you know, the shape's gonna change. Just trying to get the general colors in. At the bottom, we've got some little strawberry plants that I hope to get in. So even with these little abstract shapes, you can tell a lot about the plant. You can tell the size of the leaves and the amount of space in between them. Just shows a little bit of how it's growing. So I have this linden green, which is like this super powerful, almost neon green. And I like to mix it in with a little bit of lemon yellow to get it a little more bright. So I'm going in and trying to identify where the light is coming through. Painting is going to be really tricky because there's so many types of green, and right now they actually look very similar. Like, there's not a lot of value changes, so I'm going to try to exaggerate a little bit. Some of the tomato or strawberry plants at the bottom. Their leaves are facing an upward direction, so hopefully you can tell. Here is some really warm greens that are nice. I like to add a little bit of maybe burnt sienna, some kind of a orangey reddish color to tone it down. And then towards the bottom, add a little ultramarine blue and some white to desaturate a little. Alright, so now that I have those greens, I'm gonna try to get some of the other greens around it. And the tomato greens that are right here, there's like a patch of flowers here, and then you see the tomato greens coming in. I'm gonna try to get those. They're a little warmer than what you see up here, but I'm gonna lighten them a little and make them a little cooler than I think they are to push them back. And once you get up towards the coop, the value changes pretty stark, so I'm gonna try to show that. A lot of interesting challenges in this one. Trying to keep it pretty loose and cover this white canvas. I feel like if you leave the whites, it's pretty distracting. Some artists can pull it off though. I'm gonna put this little wooden fence back here. Hint at the post. darker really helps define the image as well. Dark here, and you can see the gate. It's kind of warmer in some areas. The gate comes towards us. It's actually a lot warmer and it's a bit lighter. It's now completely closed, but hopefully it opens back up. Wow, 22 people. Hello, everyone. I'm going in, adding this fence, trying to make sure that it's structurally semi-correct. I'm going to be going over everything, but it's good to have it kind of correct. So, a lot of plants back here, and they're a lot warmer and lighter. And what you're seeing back here is actually some really overgrown mustard greens that we never picked because we are lazy and kind of wasteful. Try not to be, but it's really hard to remember to get out there. Going around these orange yellow bits a bit. I'm not doing a very good job at that. But yeah, these mustard greens are pretty dumb. I'm gonna have to open that fence again. But right now I'm gonna just work around everything else. Let's see, I can draw, kind of sharpen the edge of the coop. Back here that I want to keep light. And there's these giant hedge things. I don't know what they're called. Kind of annoying because they block all the sun in our yard, and you know, since I love tomatoes and growing them, they require a lot of sun. That's okay. It is hot too. Okay, gonna keep this all pretty vague. Are these hedges over here? I'm sweating. Oh, it's so hot. So I'm going in. Putting in these hedges. And adding some dark shapes to make the lighter parts seem even lighter. Fence back here. I'm not going to get too detailed with it, but it's going to help push the bright spots up. I'm going to try to roughly work around it. So many shadows. I'm going to look at this gate again. So everything that I've been doing has been with pretty much these two brushes. This is a 3/4 inch and a maybe two inches or inch and a half. I have this really silvery plant right here. I really want to do a sensory garden, because when you touch its leaves, it's just so soft. And I have some lamb's ear plants next to it, which are also very soft. I think it'd be cool to have a garden that you can just go through and feel. But that's just another project for me to do. And I'm gonna extend because I don't want to put it in the sidewalk. It kind of takes away from the feeling. Same with this side. The problem with this big canvas is that I can't see what's behind it. I love painting straw. I don't know why. It's just really satisfying. Some straw here. Coming in. And I really wanted to find this path that's going in. So, I'm just always stepping back, and I think it's important to constantly check your work, take a break. Well, not, I don't really take breaks, but I like to get away from it for just a second. And my palette is really filthy right now, so I'm gonna take a second to clean it. I clean it by just spraying it down with some water and then wiping it off. Or you can even dip it into your water if it's extra cake down there. Alright. Oh, it is really hot out. So, I'm looking back at it and I'm gonna add in some brighter greens where the light's coming through. My tomato greens. I'm also well aware that I do really weird things with this hand while I paint, and I can't stop myself, so you can make fun of me all you want. So I have this chicken wire fencing around everything, which is making it a little bit tricky because it's lightening everything for me. But I want to pretend it's not there. So I'm kind of just really looking at it and paying attention to where things are darker. It's probably beneficial to work with a larger brush at this point. This one is the 1.5, so the other must have been 2. I just want to block in some of this a little bit faster. And working with a bigger brush helps you simplify it a lot better. I feel like when I'm working with small brushes and you see all those little brush strokes, it takes away from the place that you want the attention to go to. But the problem with the bigger brushes is that it's hard to fit in these wells. So, I don't know. Get some of this back. We have a lot of corn growing on the sides here. I don't think I want to. Might stick them up a little bit just to help bring the composition in. I'm trying to get the feeling of the chaotic tomato jungle that we have. So I'm kind of just moving the brush around a little bit to get different size brush strokes. And I'm squinting while I'm doing this too, because I can see the bigger masses this way. Yes, I'm going over the top of the poop. How these mustard plants are kind of sweeping into the painting. Maybe not quite that way, but so what I'm trying to do right now is I want to get this background area to be abstract, but good enough to where I can really focus in on the hops plant and the fence, so I don't even have to touch this later. So right now I'm just focusing on these spots back here. I want to get some of these really bright flowers in. I feel like these bright yellow flowers are really tricky to get. You want them to be pretty saturated for them to pop. And they're kind of orangey. They get smaller in the distance. There's kind of a mixture of yellow flowers that we have. We have a bunch of marigolds in one garden bed back there, and then it kind of extends into some wildflowers that we have here. And put some of them over here. I can never pronounce or remember the name of these flowers. I'm not even gonna try to say it, but I'll try to take a picture later. Hey guys, sorry, I'll show you my work soon.